Check with your time. It's about 46 on top of the hour, 3 p.m. Ghana time. And you know, baby, I wish you free piano. I want to specially welcome. There are a bit of clouds in the air. It is a bit near by say networking, you know, a bit tracy, but I'm trusting the Lord that we'll be able to wrap up with our studies for this Sabbath day and sana. Your Facebook, can you confirm to me, say, you can have a sustained network as well as the sound? Can you confirm to me more and more Facebook? YouTube, from my end here, no me who say sound any graphics no are okay. I don't know if you can confirm from your end say are okay for me. Na your mom pa yentua ibi me di ebusu. All right, your mom pa yena yentua yankomo di no eso. Your mom pa any di. Yet I was say, we made a rule, say, was saying, a boy and no, a woe, if you dear Muha. Ye ba ababe toa, ye disu yen so. Ye gidi ato sium, ye gidi ato baha. Na minim se unam, what don't know whom of grosso, ebe say a man. The waiting timian ye to me jina edi amount, a qua could see every year. When Pai Boni say, a tea fool, a he fool. Your war a chilly bente, beer or teeming, or because any panemoa. Mano, who munti as ye? Nasa de a decanfono eginian, yes, you to me in a mouse, as ye really do mass as he soa. What can ya can a cuckoo foa? Eginas as he so my way ready. Better was say, so a teen or any sir, to me be also one tears ye, or the man whom ne so a tear or my ashiam dee. A brain as say, and the say Christo to me as say. It didn't even fun as say my word ready. When your major or bar anyone come to me, amen. All right. Mesha mamu nyina akwa baby you. Na enure nyumre no, ebra umeda no, esha asie no. Esha asie se yedin kumoka kra. Edi afa didi a ya babisum ene eho akwantuo a yetu na yemu bebre na no ya no ena ne ye kan se ewo didi ewo urade mu but idru bra emu odin a then we become selective in the word of God na bebi a isua die ni du ye no mampese ebre no ebe ma na kopi ti se na otwitwe mu eti me ye se ye ebe ma no akobe se 2 hours se ne be ya adisua no ebe tumi aye successful for all of us in terms of consumption eti ye twaso ne wie no ene nwumri na didi kan no obi amfa ne bible na yenkin kan asembi ewo 2 Corinthians chapter number 5 verse number 20 2 Corinthians chapter number 5 verse number 20 atifias mose asumbi ene ayonkofa ho kasie the message of peace and godliness. Verse 20 no see enti yeye abofuo ema Kristo eti se onyankopon nam yeso etufo yejina Kristo anemu esremu se moma wompata entwemo emfam onyankopon ifri se die onnim bone no odine ye bone emaye na yaye onyankopon tenene Now then, we are ambassadors for Christ, as though God were pleading through us. We implore you on Christ's behalf, be reconciled to God. Ophelia Deborah is indicating that he misses RTP band. Yes, we miss them. From where they are and where I am, I am virtually impossible to have them stream, except we are at one location, and I'm sure that by the close of next week, we will resume having the ministration. Until then, we will continue to miss them. Asema Paul Ekawahei. Well, say he's speaking as an ambassador of our Lord Jesus Christ. Now, you can't be a ambassador. You represent an authority in another destination or country. Every ambassador does not become an ambassador in his own nation. You represent the authority, mostly the government authority, in another country or destination. It means that you wield the powers of your government or your authority. And see, you will be free America, ABC, Ghana, has a unina, Trump, and Emua. Say, Nipano, I wielded the authority of Trump in this country. So normal, quite simple, America. Ena America for eji watum se ena uwa hunkwa nse obeba. It is the authority is in the hands of Donald Trump as it is now, because we still having him as the president of the United States of America. There are representatives of the United Kingdom in Ghana, Switzerland in Ghana, France in Ghana, all of them omu embassies ewa. And the whole of the government in France, UK, USA, they won't be able to come here and set up. So they appoint somebody to represent the entire nation in Ghana. This any panel or Ghana or the authority of the government of France or UK or the United States. It is your number Kawaham. It is the word of the government in their respective countries. Now we know the works of Christ when he came here. We know the temptations that he went through. We know the trials, the afflictions, the agony, the torture, the massacre, the conspiracy, and all that happened to him. But Christ is no more on earth. As Danke Rade said, he groomed a few people to continue with the gospel dispensation. And those people also discipled others. And then through the discipleship, we have become disciples of our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, it is incumbent on us, the honors lies on us, that we as disciples of Jesus Christ, now ambassadors of Christ, will continue the works of our Lord Jesus Christ. So there were times when Jesus faced so much trouble because of the faith, because of what lied ahead him. He saw what was ahead him, and he knew that it was not going to be easy. Remember what the Hebrew writer said in Hebrews chapter number 12. Come to the book of Hebrews, Hebrews chapter number 12. Let's hear what the Hebrew writer said about Jesus. Because of what lied ahead him, he had to persevere. He had to stand in. He had to keep the faith. Hebrews chapter number 12, verse number 1. Down to number 4. Yeah, number 4. If RY can be quick to provide the English version. Et if you say, Mosi Yesu, ne jidini a uwi peye. Yesu, ono ne jidini a uwi peye. Adi inti na oye jidini a uwi peye. Now, Ose, senti yenso, enam se ye wo adansi fo bibri a eti se, Epay and Wesie. Moma yen to a disubia ne bonibia enche. Enche na echa ye mu esienu, emani si yen kwa imu. Na yen fab was it up into a prapere a edaye nim no mumrika. Enche didi mu keni for any de we for yeswa. O share enijia edane nim ton of wasi hunu a senior wama de. Na wen mu eni wu. Na wakotina unyankopon ahimwanifa. Na munsu suse, di oto nebuwa sinu, tiye intuye tuya no ene ene bonyefuo, wadi tuya na no bibri no huyi. Na mamre, na mokra antepiti. Mwene boni edi ya kuyi, mwene nsi ya no mkudru mwujem. Na mwure efye futuwa ekachere mose, ekachere mose ema, meba imwe radia suchi. Okay, mami fins here. Now, can I take the English version? Hebrews 12:1. No, RY Shasie free 12:1 to number 4. Let me pick the English version from here. I know the network is disrupting. I'll post it as soon as we are done with our lesson for tonight. Hebrews chapter number 12, verse number 1 to number 4. I'm taking it from here. And it reads, therefore we also, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, Adansiye Biblia etre yungwesiya no, or refer to tetefona Adansiye omunyaye. So what you see? Yeah, Aro, I know the network is breaking up, that's why. Or refer to Tetifona dance here, on say Edikanfona di Christu Nanti Omina Enya dance pa because they stood for the faith. Okay. And or Etifias must say the race of faith. That's the title. It will say, therefore, we also, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight and the sin which so easily ensnares us, and let us run with endurance the race that is set before us. Let's run with endurance the race that is set before us. Then it continues to read, looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith. Nese eye Christu pe ti asemio eye Yesu Christu pe. And I will know, obey to me every GDN because on any GDN, every year, a yep. So we have so much testimony and we share that of Christ. If you read Philippians chapter number 2, Noah, verse number 5, that was Noah. He humbled himself even to the point of death. Jesus humbled himself. It tells you that the man we are following, he stood for what he believed in. You understand? Jesus stood for what he believed in. He believed in one purpose. He believed in one mission. The entire purpose was to save humanity from damnation and to rescue the perishing. Having this purpose ahead of him, he laid aside, did not really matter. That was so much suffering. The Isaiah, the prophet, wrote about him. He said that Jesus was a man of sorrows. He was a plant that shooted and nobody recognized his comeliness. He was persecuted, he was tortured, he was insulted with all the disgrace and embarrassment. Yet Jesus stood for what he believed in. It was just but one assignment, and that was to rescue you and I from condemnation. So, as the Hebrew writer rightly said, we are surrounded by a great cloud of witnesses. And then see Bebre Netra Yemwesia. Bebre Netra Yemwesia. It is a yampodie, and kayadia di two for more, and ki wim crancesem bibri. So at yasye, you remember what happened to the Matthias Stephen? He was stoned to death because of truth. If you look at the account of Stephen in the book of Acts, you come to the book of Acts, it's quite lengthy, but shall we take the account? Because I don't want your faith to be put under scrutiny and then you end up failing. In the book of Acts, chapter number 8, if I'm not mistaken. So in chapter 8, Saul persecutes the church. Let's come to this is the sorcerer's profession. The Ethiopian man. Okay, so let me get this because it's very important. That was Stephen. He was stoned. Yes, that is Acts chapter number 7. Acts chapter number 7. They had arrested Stephen, and that was shortly after he was chosen to be a part of God's disciples, Jesus' disciples. And he was accused of blasphemy. Let's start from chapter number 6, verse number 8. And Stephen, full of faith and power, listen attentively, Acts chapter number 6, verse number 8 downwards. And Stephen, full of faith and power, did great wonders and signs among the people. Then there arose some from what is called the synagogue of the freedmen, the Syrians and Alexandrians, and those from Cilicia and Asia, disputing with Stephen. And they were not able to resist the wisdom and the spirit which he spoke. Then they secretly induced men to say, "We have heard him speak blasphemous words against Moses and God." And they stirred up the people, the elders and the scribes, and they came upon him, seized him, and brought him to the council. They also set up false witnesses who said, "This man does not cease to speak blasphemous words against the holy place and the law. For we have heard him say that this Jesus of Nazareth will destroy this place and change the customs which Moses delivered unto us." And all who sat in the council, looking steadfastly at him, saw his face as the face of an angel. The apostle Stephen had been arrested based on false allegation because he was filled with the power of God and the faith in our Lord Jesus. And the wisdom that he exhibited in his presentation was a clear sign that he was untouchable. The only reason they could bring him down was to allegate against him, which was false. All right, so we have people who came and bore false witnesses against Stephen. And on account of the false testimony, Stephen was arrested and he was made to undergo so much persecution. And guess what? In chapter number 7, verse number 1 downwards, Acts chapter number 7, verse 1 downwards, I want you to understand this scripture very carefully. Now, this is the account of Stephen before he was stoned to death. This is what the Apostle Stephen was saying. So this is Stephen's address, the call of Abraham. Then the high priest said, are these things so? They are asking him if the allegations against him are true. And he said, brethren and fathers, listen. The God of glory appeared to our father Abraham when he was in Mesopotamia, before he dwelt in Haran, and said to him, get out of your country and from your relatives and come to a land that I will show you. Then he came out of the land of the Chaldeans and dwelt in Haran. And from there, when his father was dead, he moved to this land in which you now dwell. And God gave him no inheritance in it, not even enough to set his foot on. But even when Abraham had no child, he promised to give it to him for a possession and to his descendants after him. But God spoke in this way, that his descendants would dwell in a foreign land, and that they would bring them into bondage and oppress them for 400 years. And then the nation to whom they will be in bondage, I will judge, said God. And after that, they shall come out and serve me in this place. Then he gave him a covenant of circumcision. And so Abraham begat Isaac and circumcised him on the eighth day. And Isaac begat Jacob, and Jacob begat the 12 patriarchs. All right. And the patriarchs, becoming envious, sold Joseph into Egypt. But God was with him and delivered him out of all his troubles and gave him favor and wisdom in the presence of Pharaoh, king of Egypt. And he made him governor over Egypt and all his house. Verse 11. Now a famine and great trouble came over all the land of Egypt and Canaan. And our fathers found no sustenance. But when Jacob heard that there was grain in Egypt, he sent out our fathers first. And the second time, Joseph was made known to his brothers, and Joseph's family became known to Pharaoh. 14. Then Joseph sent and called his father Jacob and all his relatives to him, 75 people. So Jacob went down to Egypt and he died, he and our fathers. Verse 16. And they were carried back to Shechem and laid in the tomb that Abraham bought for a sum of money from the sons of Hamor, the father of Shechem. Verse 17. But when the time of the promise drew near, which God has sworn to Abraham, the people grew and multiplied in Egypt till another king arose who did not know Joseph. This man dealt treacherously with our people and oppressed our forefathers, making them expose their babies so that they might not live. At this time, Moses was born and was well pleasing to God, and he was brought up in his father's house for 3 months. But when he was set out, Pharaoh's daughter took him away and brought him up as her own son. And Moses was learned in all the wisdom of the Egyptians and was mighty in words and deeds. Now, when he was 40 years old, it came into his heart to visit his brethren, the children of Israel. And seeing one of them suffer wrong, he defended and avenged who was oppressed and struck the Egyptian down. For he supposed that his brethren would have understood that God would deliver them by his hand. But they did not understand. Verse 26. And the next day, he appeared to two of them as they were fighting and tried to reconcile them, saying, men, you are brethren. Why do you wrong one another? But he who did this neighbor wrong pushed him away, saying, who made you a ruler and judge over us? Do you want to kill me as you did to the Egyptian yesterday? Then at this saying, Moses fled and became a dweller in the land of Midian, where he had 2 sons. And when 40 years had passed, it means that now he's 80 years. And when 40 years had passed, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a flame of fire, in a bush, in the wilderness of Mount Sinai. When Moses saw it, he marveled at the sight, and he drew near to observe. And the voice of the Lord came to him, saying, I am the God of your fathers, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. And Moses trembled and dared not look. Then the Lord said to him, take your sandals off your feet, For this place you stand is a holy ground. I have surely seen the oppression of my people who are in Egypt. I have heard their groaning, and I have come down to deliver them. And now, come, I will send you to Egypt. This Moses, whom they rejected, saying, who made you a ruler and judge, is the one God sent to be a ruler and a deliverer by the hand of the angel who appeared to him in the bush. He brought them out after he had shown wonders and signs in the land of Egypt and in the Red Sea and in the wilderness for 40 years. This is that Moses who said to the children of Israel, the Lord your God will raise up a prophet like me from amongst your brethren. Him you shall hear. This is he who was in the congregation in the wilderness with the angel who spoke to him on Mount Sinai, and with our fathers, the one who received the living oracles to give us, whom our fathers would not obey but rejected. Our fathers in here, the Kamfona, Womni Mosi Nantia, Omenji, Semua Mosi Ekano. Now, this is an account Stephen is giving to the council that is sitting in judgment on his case. Let's carry on. Whom our fathers would not obey but rejected, and in their heart they turned back to Egypt, saying to Aaron, make us gods to go before us. As for this Moses who brought us out of the land of Egypt, we don't know what has become of him. And they made a calf in those days, offered sacrifices to the idol, and rejoiced in the works of their own hands. Then God turned and gave them up to worship the host of the heavens. And it is written in the book of the prophet, Did you offer me slaughtered animals and sacrifices 40 years in the wilderness, O house of Israel? You also took up the tabernacle of Moloch and the star of your god Ramphan, images which you made to worship, and I will carry you away beyond Babylon. Now, verse 44, our fathers had the tabernacle of witness in the wilderness, as he appointed Moses, instructing him to make it according to the pattern he had seen with our fathers, having received it, also brought with Joshua into the land possessed by the Gentiles, whom God drove out before the face of our fathers until the days of David, who found favor before God and asked to find a dwelling for the God of Jacob. But Solomon built him a house. However, the Most High does not dwell in temples made with hands. As the prophet says, heaven is my throne and the earth is my footstool. What house will you build for me, says the Lord? Or what is the place of my rest? Has my hand not made all these things? You stiff-necked and uncircumcised in heart and ears, you always resist the Holy Spirit as your fathers did. Now, if you take verse 51 to verse 53, now, Stephen is addressing the elders, those who are sitting, we call it the Sanhedrin, all right? They are sitting in judgment upon Stephen's case, or on the count that there are allegations against himself. Stephen is speaking blasphemy. Now, listen to the message Stephen is giving them. You stiff-necked and uncircumcised in heart and ears, you always resist the Holy Spirit, as your fathers did, so do you. Which of the prophets did your fathers not persecute? Now, this is the question. Which of the prophets did your fathers not persecute? And they killed those who foretold the coming of the just one, of whom you know have now become betrayers and murderers, who have received the law by the direction of the angels and have not kept it. When they heard these things, they were cut to the heart, and they gnashed at him with their teeth. But he, being full of the Holy Spirit, gazed into the heavens and saw the glory of God, and Jesus standing at the right hand of God, and said, look, I see the heavens open, and the Son of Man standing at the right hand of God. Then they cried out with a loud voice, stopped their ears, and ran at him with one accord, and they cast him out of the city. They stoned him, and the witnesses laid down their clothes at the feet of a young man named Saul, and they stoned Stephen as he was calling on God and saying, Lord Jesus, receive my spirit. Then he knelt down and cried out with a loud voice, Lord, do not charge them with this sin. And when he heard this, he fell asleep. This is somebody who has been arrested on account of preaching the gospel. He is sharing his faith with the people. He has made known the people his faith and where he stands. As a matter of fact, when they arrested this man, he gave them an excellent message, an excellent speech, a speech I have never heard from anybody who is going to die at a point of persecution in our era. You know, when they arrested Apostle Stephen, the Bible says that he stood on his feet. He declared, he started giving the people who had assembled to persecute him the history of their forefathers. And Obi Sam said, if I should take this in P, the verse 51, Acts chapter number 7, verse 51. Let me take that in the local verse. Obi Sam, Abedjafono Messiah, Aomu Buna Tenu, Obi Sam, said, a deephone deacon, Mumu, Mumu, the Mojanum, Eddie Yawom, 51, Muamokon Asseni, Namoye Akoma, Eddie Asumu Momonoto. Da money won kunku ediesi said the mwekanum eye no sara na moye 52 a defo no mwan and a mwekanum antan na wokum won a woka otri ni no ba no ho asem kane no ono na afi moyi no ma na makuno mu amunya embra no said the abofo say no nanso mwandi so so atin komo na say these people were persecuting our Lord Jesus Christ in the times of old, and when his apostles took over, they persecuted him, and Stephen was no exception. Do you know, when Stephen lifted up his voice and looked into the skies, the Bible says that the heavens opened for him and he saw the glory of God, and he saw Jesus standing at the right hand side of God. And guess what? The people were stoning him. They were stoning him. But this man never gave up his faith. He was stoned to death. Now we come back to the book of Hebrew. We come back to the book of Hebrew, chapter number 11. To continue from where we ended yesterday. The American said, we are ambassadors. We are representing God. It is there 2 years more. By taking the name of Jesus upon ourselves, we must be ready. We must be ready as individuals to make sure say the ababa yeso ye beti eye juma say we won't deny the faith eye otaya we won't deny the faith. The systems will come against us, we don't have to deny the faith. All right, people are going to rise up against us, we don't have to deny the faith, because the moment we deny the faith, we are not worthy of Christ. Now shall we read? We are continuing from Hebrews 11. He said, oh, ambassador, now Gideon comes under persecution. You need to stand for God. You don't have to choose which of the word of God affects you and which does not affect you in bad times. So, may Sassia and be free. And now you can kind of ADBC verse 10. You will say Gideon ma ubi en to me and sweni. Now yet also every verse 11. Gideon and Sarah and Sudinya amode eny seni ye. Ebra na watana ni nini mu. Well the NT nipa bebrace or tana waria se chena eba ma na wasasiye e won chende. Ebo nyankopo sobo and bigidie nyina esa is simply because gidie na ono kaso wo no as e wanti ase ansa na oba benya sa gidie no Sarah bra na watra na wo asebo si e ka kire wa obedwin sey story obi a otena asase we su neto na anamoni nantia the way the person was able to stand for God and it twima yetros as a me father. So I wonder what is going to be written about you in the next Bible, because for many of us, we have nothing to stand for when it comes to our faith. We will fall at everything, anything. We will never stand for anything when it comes to our faith. So it continues to say Gidie and Asera edinya amwodi enyi senye. Ebra no watina ni njini mu. I'm reading from Hebrews 11 verse 11 downwards. ebra na watena ne nyinimu watra ne nyinimu efiri se obuodie ohye no bono onokwafo die ohye de bono obunu se oyonokwafo eji wampaba otena se twen didie no eji sister won't me wo oso twen wan tina didie ni mu enim se amamfo otwetwe ebinum kansa bunkuma afo wesem omo ka de fa wo eyatete but you know on the kwafo any the why day was a yembo. It is a wood year radidia. You will be stuck with a fee. Uncle want you today. Em fast adien a manen soon kuchichi a trade for so. Em mane may yo how near this offer from some find your day. Em famo. Eti enti suna oba kuwa wu yempu ewo inipa wado so sing or soro sroma ene empuanwan mia untu mi enkan. Jidye so ena yenum nyina ewu ya wansa anka boshe no. Nemo wuhunwe chiri chiri. I would like to take this part in English. I don't know why I want to do much of the lesson tonight in English, but it will give me a better exposition. Hebrews chapter number 11, verse number 13 downwards. Because this faith issue has become an... It has become a burden. Now, shall we, the heavenly hope, that's the subtitle. These all died in faith, not having received the promises. One say, heaven, na ye da, ye kan wase. Ibinom, edi omani tiyo so. Omabu, tiyo, omabu. Heaven is still a mine. But they died believing that they will make it to heaven. They died in the faith. They had this heavenly hope. And so, they were not scared to be persecuted. They were not scared to go through trauma. Na eh, how am I say, ombe fati ti, because, no me need that, osu nwa yin yeso mbono, yin yin, eno mwui. And they died believing in heaven. They died believing in heaven. Now the question I want to ask those of you who are alive. We keep on giving excuses. You say, oh, yes, obe banko waba. Yes, I say, can one send the data? Obe banko waba. Eti bebreji di atobaha. Wakan ye watre, mwosi emrende kone wia, unipandwa wome wane, anobejo. Ampa, anwajo. Edi kafona, nevye ye no maye bono. Na ye ka heaven once a matter of omujidi no emreni kwa wiye di ama omono. They rather increased in their faith. Omu dona no anu. Woma huwa dene, woma shibo ewe radimunu enjini. But ye di, emreni kwa yye wiye anu adu. And he said all of these died in faith, not having received the promises, but having seen them afar off, were assured of them, embraced them, and confessed that they were strangers and pilgrims on the earth. For those who say such things declare plainly that they seek a homeland. And truly, if they had called to mind that country from which they had not come out, they would have had the opportunity to return. But now they desire a better, that is a heavenly country. Therefore, God is not ashamed to be called their God, for he has prepared a city for them. By faith, Abraham, when he was tested, offered up Isaac. And he who had received the promises offered up his only begotten son, of whom it was said, in Isaac your seed shall be called, concluding that God was able to raise him up even from the dead, when from which he also received him in a figurative sense. By faith, Isaac blessed Jacob and Esau concerning things to come. By faith, Jacob, when he was dying, blessed each of his sons of Joseph and worshipped, leaning on the top of his staff. By faith, Joseph, when he was dying, made mention of the departure of the children of Israel and gave instructions concerning his bones. By faith, Moses, when he was born, was hidden 3 months by his parents, because they saw he was a beautiful child and they were not afraid of the king's command. By faith, Moses, when he became of age, refused to be called the son of Pharaoh's daughter, choosing rather to suffer affliction. Listen carefully. Choosing rather to suffer affliction with the people of God than to enjoy the passing pleasures of sin, esteeming the reproach of Christ greater riches than the treasures of Egypt, for he looked to the reward. I'm going to take this part in the local dialect. Verse 23, Hebrews 11, verse 23. GDA 24, GDA. Enti ena Mose nini yeno, one person yebe friend of Pharaoh baba. Na oyi se, oni onyanko pong, emay ebi huwa manie, emo chen se, obeti boni mu de eneti yebi. Obu Kristo ahohora se ahunya kesiye, sini mizrim ahunya niye, if you say, oshe aketuyamu. Jidi enti ena uja mizrim ho, na wensuro ohye mufu, na umia neni, etine mu, sendi ohunu die ohunu unono. Jidi eno didi kemu, ene muja peti eno, na emaka eno esayefu ono hankamu. By faith, he chose to suffer with the people of Israel. He chose to suffer with the Egyptians rather than the pleasures of the Egyptians. By faith, Gideon. As we say, you can't Gideon one someone. You can't Gideon one someone. Everything must be okay for you. And now you can say, who Gideon? As you say, okay for you. And now you can say, who Gideon the city. But when everything is not okay, your faith cannot be exercised. I just want to read where it matters more to me in these scriptures. Verse 30 downwards. Hebrews 11, 30 downwards. By faith, the walls of Jericho fell down after they were encircled for 7 days. How is it possible that singing and encircling round the walls of Jericho, they will collapse? Nyan sabe ni wo. Se o beto yo ma fa these great walls ho. Na e pire mo. E yi didi. If it were you, you will ask silly questions. You will say it doesn't make sense. Ade di na ose me nti na hamo. Na yariye ni beko. What medicine do we have in this akunya amenko tine mo? It was faith. By faith, the harlot, Rahab, did not perish with those who did not believe, when she had received the spies with peace. And what more shall I say? For the time would fail me to tell of Gideon, and Barak, and Samson, and Jephthah, also of David, and Samuel, and the prophets, who through faith subdued kingdoms, worked righteousness, obtained promises, stopped the mouth of lions, quenched the violence of fire, escaped the edge of the sword, out of the weakness were made strong, became valiant in battle, turned to flight the armies of aliens. Women received their dead rise again. By faith, oh! The free account maintaining called UTV, three, half you. A reality koto yi. Wase, na edye na menka biyo, na se meka Gideon, Barak, Samson, Yefta, Dewi, eni samwa niye diifono wa semwa, anka adajie ebe bome. Wana wanam jini yesu, ekudi ahiniye, ahudwosu nkudimu. Edi asentine ne, nyinya mwose, sisi ajatano, jidi enti, omu sisi ajatano, dani ya wansa mwoto. Eye okun emu awodimfo ka ananafo empeso aguye ema ensa kan won ewufo a wasoriye gidie na ebinom so wadi wan agro atopre na wan pese od wan pe odie. Some of them were persecuted and they didn't want to be delivered because of the faith. Ah, we see wan abuo Stephen the owan epai wo Saul, carpenter Saul, ya sonny nice sonny, na ya the carpentry saw, na ya the academy. GDLT. So, one thing, the granted Kunkumo, which me chili in Nantini Bridge, a woman, you know, a drew baby, in order to avoid the untimely death, no, na omakum ugain, and na aponching. Na oma de akata omo disguise ni omo. To be able to carry forward the gospel. To be able to finish the race before they die. You understand? That was faith. And no ne chere se, Christo somnua, waba abe jie chumuno, oti asie. Otaye ba, ujine mpunyane. Amanye ba, ujine mpunyane, unkobe niya. But in that Christopher one day assemble, na mudidi no atonsi. Christians have become a bunch of chickens. You cannot stand for anything. Faith comes with bravery. Faith comes with endurance. Faith comes with perseverance. Without faith, it is impossible to see God. So we see a human obey. Now did you then talk for more? And yet it's a choice you have made. But you cannot identify yourself with Christ. You cannot. Because if you read verse 35, women received their dead, raised to life again. Others were tortured, not accepting deliverance. You know, it was put before them. These are the hungry lions. Just deny the name of Jesus and go free. Hold on to the name of Jesus and the lions will become your friends. And people stood there and said, you know what? I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus, no turning back, no turning back. You understand? And they were torn limb by lions. Have you been put before a lion and instructed to deny your faith? You would have denied your faith long ago. You are afraid to talk about the gospel, the truth, to people who persecute you. Somebody is so much afraid to talk about Jesus because he thinks he is not worthy enough to preach about Christ. That's not, you don't have faith. You don't have faith. Others were taught and not accepting deliverance that they might obtain a better resurrection. Still, others have trial of mockings and scourging. Yes, and of chains and imprisonment. They were stoned. They were sawn into two. Were tempted. Were slain with a sword. They wandered about in sheepskins and goatskins, being destitute, afflicted, tormented, of whom the world was not worthy. They wandered in deserts and mountains, in dens and caves of the earth. Because of their faith. And all of these, having obtained a good testimony through faith, did not receive the promise. They did not receive the promise. When we send God was a no, and they died. And you know when they are going to hold on to the promise? At the sound of the trumpet, at the second advent of our Lord Jesus Christ. God having provided something better for us, that they should not be made perfect apart from us. And so if you continue in verse 12, say, therefore, we also, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight and the sin which will so easily ensnare us, and let us run with endurance the race that is set before us, looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith. You know, I made a decisive stand that even as I follow Jesus, I'm not turning back. And I'm not going to allow anything set me apart from the love of Christ. And from that day, I thank God that on a daily basis, God has been my strength. And I've been able to stand for Him. Now, Edruso. And I'm going to open the phone line. Yes, I'm going to open the phone lines. Those of you watching Facebook, YouTube, you're going to share with me your experience with this faith. At what point, and the name will be here, difficult, at what point? At what point? A man will give you up your faith. Yes, you're going to share your experience. I remember when things were very tough, and even we had day pan up because I said, which day and teacher, which Nikun, brown friend. Now, and even one thing. In fact, Sabreno, ye can't send pay, ye can't agree, nipping fear, minimum year, he moved come. Now, a year be my be. Or ye Nimont gold mines workers nebako. Or de asembi betu menim. Asemo de betu menim yinani se woman de gold no ko office. Na gold no consignment bako oma balance ya empeni fweni ma so but ase the cover is about to be blown. Eti kame mana kwansere. Na etuncha echirin kata. I say, "Omo to be cotton good, noa. Adie bi a me pe as nyami ni paro. Ombe ya mami se sare dan kwa ombe tas asiesi aso dan to ka mami atu instrument mami. Nti okase wi ye no oto no boto no kwa envelope. Be kai pa sika na ewo sa envelope no 25 million ewie bi a mi wofi. Menye na memfa emo makwanchire na omo mfa cotton good." Because in this happened, no, a hutchery womb, and it was like good news for me, because me nim say me no me ni nyame ne nam eti ni me catch them so mum koi biya no darish biya de be mo so biya be edu, erade jima no assemble too ti me catch mum koi biya be edu, ti me face kai me blue dem wa me yes me de be two table so na eni bi catch them say, uji sika we ya, what next? One next. It is me sambechi na me buy. We both si kana su 25 million. Sabri ne nyis kaketua. Anka kwama e deme ne me yiri. E ne ahochera beto yesu ne e kame didi ya mintu mintuya. E kame didi nina su ye vegetables in ketua atosodie. Garden eggs ne nye me bia. Miku free. E wokura na me woso no miku free. Ne di ababi yedu ya nyedi. You can imagine 5 cities, 10 cities are the free credit. That was how terrible it was. Now out of the blue, we did 25 million about. It will solve all the problems, financial problems around me. Near the rent in Soka. Ye light bill ye to mean to ya. Ubiya omuji did light the normal drum is what me niska. And it was not a near nyai. No, we did 25 million about. And it was within my power to give a direction so that they will go and get success. You know, I came back with the money and told the man, say, we'll be in the man with you now on where you are. On sign the man who found a dianya in command about it, so food. We'll be the kind of feeding the man. Now, say, be car and sign of what you see about it. In fact, the catcher reminded me, say, when you're coupon or when you're na ene ma pa ewe nya me nsem no ne ma eno de ma wo enso me check ye no onye nya me ba nya me akwanchire ewo ho ma nya me ma wonye nya me ba eji nya me ntumi ma wo akwanchire bia eji unim odi eji usika meko na me efutu a me de be ma wo ne se nkebe ya mo nsem fa good no ni urade enko ma no isan se juma na mo ye no se nya me su obi shira wa enye gold na mo kwa kofa ne biye shira de mo And that was a very nice temptation, a very juicy one. Me ho chire me papa. But unim, over the years, anytime I'm casting my mind back, me de onyanko po ase se, oma san so me no ba makwe, oma kwae ma se tan me so mi vey, ne ye so re nyami ya makwe se embe so mi jidi no. Me na me se me kenya mi ase, me na me se me kano kwe, ato me. Sabre no me yesu yo se na osoro ni amofo no bi a twen ho womu nyina tan di omo twen ye Bernard ebeye se Bernard ebe jai no kure mato waji sika no na se obi jina mawurade aka no kure no bra enye memu odi asedan ko nyankopon na meka sa asem we di wo me hu wo Kristo mu se sa test no wa because be bia na ye ho chiri ye kodu no kwasem ye. On the first count, I was tempted to take the money. On the first count, I was tempted to take the money. But guess what? Yes, I'm this kind of 2 tables. So no. And then they be catching me say, you will take it and what next? I came and told the man, take your money, go back. Now, maybe a future of the man said, can they ya? Go, no. Mufanko Madura. Then Yamisu Bishrawa. And you will be at the end of the fasodiation. The man got angry. He left, drove off with speed. Maybe my camera no crevy, me gusu etchere me kom. I come be na a drew baby no me tnasi being one number. Ah, she came. Ah, well, then I make no ye. And also, yes, kapow, me jason can ye. A fee, me a ma passing so and I'm a santi ho. Every room, I didn't need a money. As soon as I saw a passing me, my passing. Guess what? About 8 months, almost 9 months down the line, almost a year, me all one day, and I can't be parking. Nipane by ya, Nincomuni, and say, Semekainua, and Pammy Ren and Nimnes, I might know about me change some time back or the 25 million by that afternoon now or by. Or my 4,000 Ghana cedis. Now some of this is kind of man. Now some of can you? Or say so for? When you be here, Masamba. So I say now can you? I name it. Me bufui. But me now kwanso ameko. I say no. It kept ringing bell in my ears. Na me kai pass. I will catch them. Say, Senya me be siramia. And you will be good. Na me fanu no be siramia. I name it. Iti migusu a mebin bin hombra mi di mi ka meko. Ene besi ma dream se na se echire yi hu echire ne pamu mi fre aduma no moye. Na se bibi a bom. Me ni begu ase metumi asa ko da fi ase because abrofu yi once you steal from them and the Lord casts up with you, you go to prison. Iti no after giving it careful thought no. I made up my mind to return the gold and we returned it just as you said. Now me returning gold no. That week, no one or more memo ever say, I have been promoted to the next rank of my position. And my salary was tripled. It was not double, it was tripled. And I was given higher incentives and better packages. And from that day, my life has never been the same. But I remember, say, when I came to you, you gave me the key. And I, a brother, you promote me, not your mommy. Abasobodia any triple salary na mami who say you are a true man of God. It I have come just to thank you for making me a child of God. From that day, me nyame som mentiasie manfesi keni brensi meni subiu. Before I came to you, I understood life to be all about money. But after listening to you and going in anger, I realized that this life is not all about money. Sisi a menyes ka manabro meso. Manguya, a jumana meye noa, babeye penipa. It is the suffer. I came to thank you for guiding me and for telling me the truth, even though it was bitter. That more afternoon, he gave me 4,000 cedis. That time also, no, I didn't need money for anything. Mocho, or the 40 million buyer, I didn't need money for anything. That would be 25 million buyer, I needed money for many things. Sanu Nyankopon Oyenadi. And as I speak with you today, or a very prominent man with a lot of money, but through righteous means. Or that's why you have to be company did almost GDD be to us here. And the Yammy day would need your name to say, or sign you your copomba. Heaven, secret to signing the new Yamua, because the dear new Yam say, mine will be your heaven, Nibiaco. If you want Yammy someone to tell us, I stood for the faith. It's you know, any time he will go somewhere, what do you think? I don't see a man will be there for me. He is one of the people who has been the backbone to this ministry. He does not hesitate to help whenever the need arises. You know, when you stand for your faith, when you believe in the God you serve and you stand with him in bad times, he will honor you. And tonight, before we bring the Sabbath to an end, I want you to carefully think about it. I have shared one of my testimonies with you. These are the kinds of testimonies that I expect people to bring up. Standing for the faith, defending the faith, contending for the faith. So we man yankopon and you nyam. Adeadi e will be penny so. Brighten the corner where you are. Papa no baby obeku biya no. Asema obeka fan no. Eye be a tree in nipa. Ebo yankopon dasi. Nasema oka nyina ne sese wo pe obi a obekere okwampa no akohemia kotena so fo benan nasi na obinya hemia ko e yo no na mama tinya me sumase ozu e ababa wa wo kwa kopa eduma e de ka kire so eduma na wo hopa but ansana me eduma no sabe ka na je se ne oda ampa open so na one ne die me patu. What description of Christianity have you given to your boss? O boss na o ma nene ne wo die papa na o ma nene wo die ansa na di eduma ne ma wo adwin ben do kura fa wo o sori na wo ko asori kwesi ada na wo hu se wo ko asori kwesi ada o fi sa adwin ben eno what kind of opinion and a perception does he hold of you? So what you see e dia ben, what is it about you a be ma no ono asatra na na dwin ne wo ko asori? Because what crowd see we hear Christ on in our Bible page, you man. Oh, boy, gamai. Oh, man, any more. Oh, man, any more. Boy, gamai. I said, you man, oh, yeah. So you didn't stand for Christ. So you are the better. I said, you man, oh, Papa. Me ye Christ on in Baba. Me yes, I'm on the way. A woman who fit a woman, you mean, you want to see that. It would be, you man, oh, dear, Fama, oh, Mama. That say, oh, Baba. And the new Christ on over page, you man, on any beda. A yamau, but maybe a banadia, mean yes, I'm only with Yam in Yakupo. And then Kadumanenka. What can come what the accident on our call? Come my next Yakuyamua, or better see D, or begging to King. Bawodi Ababawa, and yes, sir. When we are investing, if you knew Yaguma, so you are desperate. Because of that, desperate times calls for desperate measures. Now, Nina da, and Yakuma. What good Yami anymore? What I say, when could you anymore say? You did not become an ambassador. No, your representation is not complete. Un sam fata Christu. So I say, un sam fata no. And there are many of us in many aspects of our lives. And you, we are dead. And then. And that the same one baba yet day in Europe. Un in krata. Na ye be ayen sempi. Na san krata semwi edi nipa bebri. A kwaku pia manone ebeko bonsam jem. En krata semno. En krata semno. Edi mumu bebri ebeko bonsam jem. Eti I'm looking forward say. Yeah, it is possible they will deport you into Ghana. Adey, baby anyhow. When you allow your faith to stand, and you get deported. Nyami bebu obe saluti. One say, okay, now I know you will stand for me in every situation. He will give you breakthroughs. You want to see the power of God. You want to see the miracles of God. You want to record genuine testimonies in your life. Stand for your faith. And you record them. You record them on a daily basis. Because I am recording. You understand? I am recording. So I'm wondering what your testimony is in the regard of this particular lesson. I'm wondering, GDNO, what was the point? What point was your faith tested? And how did you stand for God? At what point the faith of Job was tested? He passed. The year they catch and say, "Ora, do me unya kuponi wuwache." Etu da sukra umu diemu krasa inyami imu. Pasa. I think you are getting it all wrong. Job say, "Oba, oba, ade na ukasa se ema jiji trifu ibi, eh? Ema jimi fu ibi, omukasa na uka." Time and niema yenu diye open eso. Eniema yenu, eniema mu yenu diye ujitu. Papa ba yenu oje, mwone na ba wonye. Pati ya sema Job kai, ujinae. Ne nao fufuomu njina rejecte no the man to. He was a man like you and I. Edru uso, ediena yenchi nofawo. Odi ya kachira me. So ade siye, afeina adienu edru uso, odi ya kachira me. Metro, mesas yenchi nofawo. Ediena yenchi nofawo, Kristu ni. Ediena yenchi nofawo. So I tell you, Mumu Bebre, you have sold out your Jesus. You have betrayed Jesus because of a name beer, a beer. Difficult in your life. You betrayed a man. You betrayed Jesus. And for many of you, you keep on betraying them. It is for immigration reasons you betray Jesus. You lie. Because you want a man to get married to you. You help bent. What do you want to do in the air? Look at the kind of life you're living. Yeah, get pregnant for me before I go to perform your bride, pay your bride price or perform the marriage rites. You are afraid that you will lose the man. You are not afraid that you will lose Jesus' contact in your life. You are afraid that you will lose a mere mortal man. Who can even disappoint you in the course of the marriage? Who can even cheat on you in the course of the marriage? You fear losing that man. Because of that, you get pregnant out of wedlock. You want to secure the man with the pregnancy. What if you get pregnant and the man dies? Where will your Jesus be? If you get pregnant and your man dies, the man you want to secure with a pregnancy, where will your Jesus be after his death? Please, oh, will you come back to Jesus and talk to him about what is happening in your life and the fact that you are pregnant and the man is dead? Yeah, what story are you going to tell your child when you finally put the child to rest or give birth to that child? So you see, our Christian walk has been undermined with the several betrayals we put up when things get tough in our lives. Mumu beble mu wa gana ha, and sema muti, gana ha na mu wano enti, aye easy for you to serve God. It is many of these things you think you are not affected, but I'm telling you, go to the markets. And what will be the practicality of what I'm talking about? And the memoir, the titu pandemic, he buy you kuradi. A man from Fangun we bruna, Unia, so do Unia to sell Hua. So do Unia to sell Hua. They say, ya total bodies, goods and services, and flu ye. It is the letter now, you have hyped the prices, you have escalated the prices, you have inflated the prices, making it impossible for the poor woman to purchase what he was capable of purchasing in the few years, in the few months past. You are just betraying Jesus with your lifestyle. 0244765050. 0244765050. Oh, a question, friend Ebusa. Those of you watching on Facebook, YouTube, oh, a question, Ebusa. An experience to share with us. It shouldn't only be the positive one. All right? It shouldn't be only the positive one. You know, let me tell you the downside of my faith. The downside. Abraham was secondary school. Me baby wey secondary school me fa girlfriend bi. Na na me ye boring boyfriend because ye friend bi krefe. Krefe me don kwachiri kakra. That's about 32-35 years back. Right? Me do kwachiri. No, that's about 28-29 years back. Me do kwachiri kakra. Na sa girlfriend na me fa na ni din di Emilia. Make us a cry be an old shame. Now, certain I was almost like a youth pastor because I was the president for the Ghana National Association of Adventist Students, Koforidua, New Gabon chapter. Honona, a Koforidua Polytechnic, any secondary schools now. A walk of food beginning in a normal was your friends and nurse chapter. No, I say it is a tech, no one way, kicker on your normal war, and I was their president. So I was equally a pastor, a youth pastor, because now we could not pop with a chi a Kenya Miasa. Me observe Sabbath. Now, I want him a brave baby secondary school, and I gave it a gamine. A hammer, I always say, and I put it on record, say, at that time, na mi hu obada. Sabre no, na mi si ya obada, mi nim obada. Sabi yo mani mwa, na mi nim kwa se kwa ene ye tu. I didn't know where to go or where to come. So ati komona say, instead of standing on my grounds and defending my faith, obani ye ya na mi die, o ripu mi. Anyway, it was consensual, so I won't call it a rape again. But the downside of it is, I betrayed Jesus. And you know, something unique happened in my life. The man here unique, he said, before sir, a gamamono, now there a ye fear, a bit minimum. Minima dear ye fear, minim a dear friend fear, even. Before sir, a gamamono, me nya obia ubetimi ya dia nya, I will keep quiet. But my principles were as stiff as ever. It is both teachers and prefects, no musumi. Even the headmaster of the school, they were very careful dealing with me because sabre na I have not betrayed my faith. Me mumi hufi. It must send bia make me ya. The free time I'm in boss head man na intro e back out my brother. Afi, adi esese me kano kure, na mi di intro. A home feeling the absence of God, I felt something leaving me, and obviously, the Spirit of God had left. I did not have any enthusiasm. Mi niya unkebiya mnebefa Bible working kind. I was hesitant to prayer. Adi embiya eye divine nature, spiritual nature ho, na mi mpebi. I had betrayed Jesus with my girlfriend. You understand? But thank God say, Bonkronkronu free mi muno, wankwechiri. He kept nagging my mind. Why ya di enye? And for a week and more, I was so down. I was so sad. I cried. I shed tears. I wept and asked for mercy. After 3 months, I saw a restoration. The guilt, the burden of guilt was taken away from me. And within the scope of 3 years, I was able to overcome that ekamambo. And once again, when I dedicated myself to holiness, the Spirit of God filled me. So I learned my lesson from there. The question I'm asking you is, I didn't know that's where your mind was on them, or that you feel comfortable. Because I didn't feel comfortable. I did not. I knew something terrible was wrong with my system. I felt it. Even as young at that time, I felt it. I knew what it meant for you to be filled with the Spirit of God. I didn't know what you saw them now. Now feeling comfortable. Is that your faith? Is that your faith? Give me a better way to express your faith, and I'll believe in you. It is a niema bone. Eba wakwemua. Stand for your faith. Send him a pa, eba wakwemua, stand for your faith. Say ubewua, stand in the faith. Obenyam kwa stand in the field. We yare na unya yare sa. Stand in the field. Ayare sa maya stand in the field. Ejuma sembe nye ya stand in the field. Ye ya stand in the field. In good and bad times, remain in the field. Die for the field. You must have a reason to die. If I'm going to be slaughtered, if I'm going to be imprisoned because of the truth, so be it. And this was the spirit that Odin's had. Our forefathers, we need to deal with them. And not the shape of mental conditioning. So what I say, and the shape of matter. Asemno, we are not part of it. But the asemno, everybody we are. Now, before I become, just in case you have a question, you can call through. I'll put you through in the liberty, and then we will answer it for you. So, only question be answered. But the Alisuano, everybody we are. A boy, ye baby, see on your coupon, they say. If free and net day echo, a bread you made day ever the weeing, if free sabre echo. Say, and so she be a buyer queen. Now we need to choose between the flesh and the spiritual. We will crucify the flesh and walk in the spirit. Say, ye jumampu ene bese ya, we are ready to lose our jobs and defend the faith. Say, ya warri ene bese ya, we are ready to defend the faith and lose our marriage. Say, ye ma ene biwa, ye me kanabo kosi no sento wa, say, drew critical necessity will buy you. So you will defend your faith. Go and disappoint God. It you are him say. Whoa, we are to end, you know. Say, won't to me say, yame bo. And I say, won't to me actually. And defend you what did you know? Because here we are. You are not worthy of Christ. And only a single. You are not worthy of Christ. All right. It's yemu dudua. Ye pese from today, you take this decisive stand. Say erade, uwomo, enkwemo, papemo, bonimo. Oka nyomna, ayi nkofu wetu ye papemo, bonimo, minyami ane wa o. Papa mo boni mo peda was ya bribia ye wo mere mu ye den ye wo mere mu ye den boni to me bawo owo to me bawo amani to me bawo eso we to me bawo eso ni nyinye nyinye chi ye ri nya we chi ri di ada o papa mo boni mo Minya miya ne wawo, pape mo, boni mo, bedawa siya bribia. I made that decision years ago. And found it in better me as I see so. Whether in good health or in bad health, in good standing or in bad standing, in poverty or in riches. And that is why even in poverty, I stood for Christ. And I stood for him so faithfully. A hokrapona, I won't tell him about the big cream more emerade. Jimmy Menamono, me to me, I want to say a hotel. Menamon, me to me, I want to blame more dim bar. When there is nothing, a home na big dim moon, a increasing. I want to bar, I am not, and my memory relaxes it, you know. I always want to go through difficult moments, difficult problems. Hard times, that's what I always desire to go through. But I don't know about you. It is only himself you will be able to make this deciding standard. Just give me, yes, I will do. Just do that. You don't just have to say, just give me a sign, a thumbs up. You give me thumbs up. And I know I have people with me in the mood. And I'm asking for the strength of God to be with you from this day henceforth. I'm about to answer your questions. Question Bakua Abba any Ophelia Deborah or say, Daddy, please, what is faith and hope? Is it the same thing? No. Question I will be saying, say, Gidea and Yadidaso, a dear Bakua, and Debbie and Yadia Bako. And it is so, I a friend of hope, no, eh, dear, in yam memo, tio, eh, dear, in yam mind. But when it does so, it is when you want to define faith, GD, hope is found in faith. You cannot find faith in hope, but you find hope in faith. So who did ya? Eni daso no ebeba. Did ya ni mwa eni daso ni mu. Meni daso say me sabeka penwe. It is a meni daso say me sabeka penwe dia. Ena nache se majie di se pen ebeba. Iti na meni meni atoso. So what ya siye? Iti adie biya weni daso say wong sabeka no. E ye jidye na ma se ni da so na ede aba. E di jidye enonde e give you birth to hope. Without faith, hope is absent. E ti oni pe biara onye ni da so wa sa si so no ni jidye. You must have faith before hope will come into play. Afe RY SUB says, please, Father, I have a question. Why is it that men of God can pray for someone to receive a breakthrough like healing in their situation, but after many prayers, still no answer comes from God? Why is it that men of God can pray for someone to receive a breakthrough like healing in their situations? But after many years, still no answer comes through. RY, I want you to clarify the question for me. Is it the men of God who are sick by themselves and they are asking God to heal them or give them breakthrough and they are not getting? Or they are praying for other people and they are not getting? RY, can you please clarify? If possible, you can call through the line and then clarify the question for me to answer for you. I have Vadis Yeboah indicating that he is going to defend the faith. I have John Echo Emisa saying he is going to defend the faith. I have Jane and Rickett saying he is going to defend the faith. R.Y. saying, Mr. Samuel Furiata saying, Grace Nimo saying, Nanaya Sewa saying, Eva Amua saying, Charity Ajayi saying. All right. For those of us who are committed to defending the faith from today, no matter what, and found say, we are all abrichira, we do my best say, ye babu wa bagana, and ye mabe ye basa. If you're going to stand for the faith, we will gana ha, the bribing system, and the corrupting system, and all that, you're going to stand and defend the faith, your faith, so that it becomes a testimony unto the world. And the world will know that, oh, we still have genuine Christians in this end time. Ekuya Ekolete is also saying same. He was 10. For those of us who are making this commitment, I'll be saying a special prayer with you today. And I'll be asking God to come into you and be your strength. And I know times will come, God will leave you alone to suffer the consequences of your decision. And when it comes to that point, you will depend on your inner strength to walk with God. That time will come. So you must understand what you are bargaining for today. You may not have had anything to stand for, but you're going to stand for something. and everything today, all the days of your life. Till death do us apart. I'm waiting for the clarification on ROI's question. And then Ms. Oforiatta will be on standby to say a word of prayer with us. Ms. Oforiatta, AB and Alfre, through WhatsApp, Noah, not network, no, I have been. It you know, say, me mark green light, and he said, your mom, Paya, I'll call you through the normal line, and then you pray with us to end the Sabbath for today. Then I will conclude the entire session praying with those who have made a commitment to defend the faith till death do them apart. All right, Arwai, you're asking this question in respect of men of God praying for members for them to be healed. And they pray many times and the healing doesn't come. The question is the rationale behind the prayer. You know, the reason many prayers go unanswered, I think we should be discussing this. Why we do see some prayers and the prayers do not come answered. Alright, kindly jot this one down so that within the week, you know, maybe I am fine midweek, you discussing this particular topic. Sometimes in Wayano Emma, we'll look at some of the factors that account for this biblically. So Alright, I would like to answer your question with a teaching so it becomes clearer for all of us. Etihu sun nyamiana obonsam minua weya sem bisama wo dwenewo minua ba dwenewo minua bema abrabo fui tumi to wonkwa lada. All right, me baba friend sa ufuri ata na oniye abompaye na wasiro nyankopon ho mogrohunu na wasiri nyame ho nsem enhyira bra yedi humeda iso na ye ne konkon na ewia akọ toyi na nti calling Mr. Oforiatta on the phone so that he will pray with us na yedi humeda no abane wi ye Mr. Oforiatta ebo mpa yi wi a na me so ma bo mpa ye for one more, I make a commitment with God. So let's get Mr. Oforiatta on the line to pray with us. Our home. All right.
Jesus, asana, waba, Jimmy Free, yasi, Bonnie, Ninemo, asana, waba. Ampara Jesus, oh, Zizieno, Azana Waba, Jimmy Free, Yasi, Bonnie, Nemo, Azana Waba. Emratu ninemo azana awaba.
Jide fuwe nina anka amen kesiye pa. afei obia wa make commitment to defend the faith, to contend for the faith that was once for all given to the saints, and to stand for the faith till death do you part. I just want you to raise both hands just as I have done, and let's receive the strength from the Lord to be able to carry out our mandates on this earth. Shall we? Ahodimu ahodimfo ene wasafurade. Wodi ewun tu sa ema wuni nchuda. Ubiya pese koko okuma. Na watun sa edi afreo. If you say wodi e, woye patakon ajekon abo obo. Enumrei. Umede yi eba ne wye yi. Mede woma wetu onwe siho. Se ifri sabre ko jidia edikanfono ewumanye. Jidia wamu jina anuwa. Wamu jidia iti. Ibinom ajata ewe wamu. Ibinom yedinkrante eni soa wamso. Ibinom ekugu efiase. Yedi ibinom egu jemu. Jidia no. Emrepa ene mrebonimu no. Wamu jina edimao. Sa jidia no. Edru yen so no ye kam wo ye no keke adanse ye nim enunti ene wiase afa kristo sum se efo enunti ene wiase ehunu se tumi bia enni ye kristo sum wa ene abanim. We are so powerless. The church has become so weak. The reason being that we are not able to stand for the faith. And so you don't prove yourself in the long run. Say yadia ye jinama we radia. And ye be sign sentin mia kasia 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 kasia. And they can follow isisi yeno. Today we have made a commitment to stand for you in our private lives, in our public lives. Say ya bontain, say ye kukwem. Ye si ejinai se Kristo. Udina ya fatu ya mosono. We will stand for the faith. Se yariye mumpa. We will stand for this faith. Even in the prisons. We will stand for this faith. When we are posed with threats and danger. We will stand for this faith. We will invest in your kingdom because of this faith. Say di dia we and a ma and the can for no et me ton wa japa de nom de sikana shim. Many a dance ni a medikan or sru di me wa dance ye. Se ma de nyina be di ye wo duma. And no and a woman a si a jina say and ne they will stand for the faith. Defend the faith, contend for the faith. Till death do us apart. So I bring them before you. Just as the Apostle Paul said, Mon shemi suyame. Said they behave a Christ to be suyame. But here was suyame. What the one part of what it's let's say, Bibia will be our own mind. And nothing I mean, so me, Dimi Bibia. It is on my ass here, did I say, they will stand for the faith. Bra yuska, bra yiniska, my yinina mau. Bra yuan wode, bra yinia wode, my yinina mau. And the guasimu, my yinina mau. Because anybody be brave and you nyamba and omu tumi jina. And in guasye ba dia, no omu feri omu tumi jina. But ene, be sila won sam adomni ya woden se, odi pe biyala. A we siye jina yi se, wo be jina e diya me jidi yi. Kristo, ma jidi ya ene, ye sinipi. Wo ya brabom, ya dada sitinem, ya jumem, ya safum, ya wariyem. Jidi ya ye sinipi, ye kunum ni anim. Your yenum and him, your man him, your bosses and him, our employers and him, Jidia Yesini P and the Deino. Let us send a new wave of information. Let us send a new wave of description about our faith in our Lord Jesus. Let it bring a vivid description of the ancient faith that was bequeathed to us. Today we are receiving the empowerment of your spirit.
that in bad times and good times, we will not be selective of your words, but we shall do as you have said all the days of our lives. How can we do this when we are not able to stand for ourselves and what we believe in? So today, just as our elder brother prayed ahead of me, increase our faith, build our faith, groom us. Se nipa nyina ebiyiwa ma me Bernard me gina ma se nipa nyina beyiwa ma wo meya wo ma mom sasu omo be gina ma eti erade boye Christo boye esan se ewiase we would not make it easy for us. It was not easy for the people of old. They faced more challenging and terrible persecutions than our time. In our time, it is more of an intellectual persecution. It is more of a wisdomized persecution. Our time is absent with physical persecution. They were threatened with sword. They were threatened with fire. Yet, amidst the danger they stood for you. So we have had the easy way out, but we are not able to stand for you. But for those of us that have lifted our arms, we are relinquishing our will unto you, that Father, your will be done in our lives, and that we shall not be afraid to die, go to prison, be disgraced, be embarrassed for your name. Because you prayed on the Mount Olives that for my name's sake you are persecuted, my name's sake you are castigated, my name's sake they will say all manner of things against you. Rejoice and be exceedingly glad, for great is your reward in heaven. We want to cling on to that teaching, and we want to make it so practical in our lives from this day henceforth, that we will never disappoint you. So God, help us. Help all of us. I know the demand will be placed. I know the devil has recorded this prayer, and he will come hitting us so hard. But we are a prepared army for our Lord Jesus. We thank you for giving us this opportunity, for renewing our faith in you, and for giving us a reminder that if we want to record miracles, your miraculous hand, if we want it to prevail amongst us, then we must stand for you. Until we stand for you, we will not see your power. The church lost its power because it was not able to stand for you. So today, we are making a commitment to stand for you. So in the end, your powers, your healing powers, your miraculous signs will be enshrined. The dead will rise at the voice or at the sound of our voice. The dead will rise because we're going to stand for you. Healings will take place because we're going to stand for you. And the devil cannot stop us because you are our rock of ages. Thank you, Father, for listening to our solemn prayer this evening. Afei, wosemu shira. Wo se yembo. Se yankwati womeda no anye de yepe. Ya anye de yankase yepe. Nemo yehwe womeda ne di sokronkron. Wo ya nokwafo, obehwie womeda mu shira de guye so. Wo baba ye homa ye fie bua, ye bifie e bibia. Enuti enumrei. Womeda wra, fie se shira ne guye so. Let the showers of blessing be our portion. Keep us safe throughout the course of the week. The send a watchful for us say, me pay money say, ye difi ye fi me moye humbani. E ma money bi makaya yi. Say it and a fidi ye bi yo susum ye no mi jino guamani mo jemu e dismantle. And I call for the reinforcement of your angels to come and guard your people. We shall assemble again next summer and we shall give you glory. Omo yusandu yuma, siri shira so. Wamusika sem shesoma wo. Oma pumudi shesoma wo. Wamumba siesi wo. And yonyam enyo modia. Awarepa enyo modia. And the pa ewa wo storehouse enyo media. Because they have kept your word. Thank you for the privilege you have given me as their leader. Thank you for the honor you have given me as their leader. Continue to assist me in dispensing your duties, your assignment to humanity, with all sincerity, loyalty, and faithfulness, so that we shall meet in heaven when the time is nigh. In the name of Jesus, we have prayed. Amen. Shall we share the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Christo Tiasi, you be one new now. See ya, dear. Heaven, our home. Yadi Adisuani, Abba, the Wee.